not let this republic be split in two. My negotiations will not fail.
If they do, there aren't enough Jedi to protect the republic. We're keepers of the peace, not soldiers.
You know I don't like it when you do that.
Sorry, Master. I forgot you don't like flying. Well, you've lost it.
If you'll excuse me.
I hate it when he does that.
Anakin, don't do anything without first consulting either myself or the Council.
You don't need guidance, Anakin. I see you becoming the greatest of all Jedi.
The boy has exceptional skills.
His abilities have made him arrogant.
Excuse me. I'm in charge of security here, m'lady.
Named Jango Fett to create a clone army.
Wait.
We must stop them before they're ready.
Your clones are very impressive.
They'll do their job well.
Blast, that's why I hate flying.
This is a crisis. The Senate must vote the Chancellor emergency powers.
As my first act, I will create a grand army of the Republic to counter the increasing threats of the Separatists.
There hasn't been a full-scale war since the formation of the Republic.
You must join me, Obi-Wan, and together we will destroy the Sith.
The dark side clouds everything. In grave danger you are. Gun this Clone War has.
Bienvenidos a este especial de Star Wars, episodio 2. Nos encontramos en las afueras de San Francisco. Este es el digamos, el lugar que se llama Marín, que es donde está también ubicado nada más y nada menos que el Skywalker Ranch, que es el lugar donde vive George Lucas y donde también él produce gran parte de sus trabajos. Acá tiene de todo, tiene sus oficinas, tiene un spa, tiene de todo. Y un ratito vamos a estar viendo también en este programa especial todos los lugares. Ponemos una cámara dentro de este rancho. Y además nos vamos a estar encontrando con todos los actores y todos los secretos de cómo se hizo esta película tan increíble. Episodio 2, entonces, Star Wars, aquí en este especial.
El más reciente capítulo de la saga de Lucas, La Guerra de las Galaxias, Episodio 2, El Ataque de los Clones, se desarrolla 10 años después de los eventos acontecidos en Episodio 1, La Amenaza Fantasma. La República continúa en un conflicto y en caos. Se inicia un movimiento separatista que crea una legión de clones listos para luchar. Además, se inicia una fuerte historia de amor entre Anakin, que ya dejó de ser un niño, y Amidala, una historia de amor que marcará el destino de Star Wars. Esta escena de lluvia que estamos viendo y que en la película se desarrolla en el planeta de los clones, se grabó en un estudio y se utilizaron más de 100.000 litros de agua para grabarla varias veces hasta lograr la imagen perfecta y la expresión de lucha y terror del actor que pasa todo un día bajo agua.
Hi. Thank you for inviting us to your ranch. It's a beautiful place here.
Yeah, you're welcome.
It's huge also. It's really nice here. It must be a lot of pleasure and also pretty exhausting, no? Doing a huge movie like this one.
It's a lot of work. It takes 3 years, and it's 3 years of very constant hard work, so it's nice to have it finished.
Y miren esta escena.
You know I don't like it when you do that.
Sorry, Master. I forgot you don't like flying.
Estas escenas de vuelo se hacen de la manera tradicional, con el famoso ventilador para dar efecto de vuelo, un aparato que al mejor estilo de los juegos de parques de diversiones se mueve para un lado y para el otro, y rodeado por una tela azul que luego a través de una computadora se reemplaza por un fondo de cielo y da la sensación de que el actor está volando entre edificios y esquivando peligros.
And casting must be also hard work because a lot of, I mean, young boys wanted to be Anakin and you chose Hayden and... Yeah. It must be really tough seeing so many actors and deciding which one is the right one for you.
Well, we worked for a year, saw hundreds of actors, and you keep narrowing it down and doing tests and readings and that sort of thing, and eventually brought Natalie in and saw how the chemistry worked between the two of them. And, you know, it's a very hard choice, but it's a very important choice.
How was it when you heard the news about you have been cast? I was talking to George Lucas. It was like a lot of actors were seeking that role, so must be...
Yeah, it was. It took me by surprise, but you know, it was absolutely thrilling. I was overwhelmed with joy. you know, it was a good week of being on cloud nine, and just in complete disbelief.
When you heard the news, where were you?
I was actually in Vancouver. I was doing a television series there, and I was living with my roommate. And he actually handed me the phone while I was still in bed, and got the news in bed.
How was it for Hayden the day you told him you are Anakin?
Yeah, he was very excited.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Natalie Portman empezó en Star Wars Episodio 1 y fue seleccionada con solo 14 años de edad para ser de Reina. No disfrutó de la filmación de la primera parte porque dice era demasiado chica y sufría filmando con tantos efectos y tanta presión. Pero en esta segunda parte, ya mayor, aprendió a relajarse y disfrutarlo y llevó a tres amigos de su facultad a los sets de filmación de todo el mundo.
Was it as exciting for you this time? This is the second time, and always it's just Star Wars. I know what it is. What is it about?
Absolutely, it's always really exciting because there's so much of the unknown in it. Because while you're filming, there's nothing around you. Everything's put in later, so it's always exciting because it's always, you know, you're always in anticipation of seeing the finished product, which is a 2-year process. So
we need a system where the politicians sit down and discuss the problem, agree what's in the best interest of all the people, and then do it.
That's exactly what we do. The trouble is that people don't always agree.
Well, then they should be made to.
Sounds an awful lot like a dictatorship to me.
Well, if it works.
You're making fun of me.
No, I'd be much too frightened to tease a senator.
Los actores debían firmar un contrato de confidencialidad porque mucha gente quería saber sobre cómo era el libro y cómo era esta segunda parte, y hasta llegó a evaluarse muy alto cualquier dato privado, como nos contó Christopher Lee.
There were problems at one time. When I did Star Wars, an offer was made for the script of Star Wars. $150,000.
Wow.
For a collector. Somebody did something very foolish and they're in prison.
You didn't have to sign anything like fidelity that you couldn't talk to anybody about it, or?
No, I knew not to. I mean, if I didn't want to die in that one, I knew not to talk to anybody. There's consequences.
The script came in your script.
Exactly.
He died.
Yeah. And if you talk, you die. Yeah.
Las horas de maquillaje se iniciaban a las 4 de la mañana, en especial para todos los que tenían agregados en sus caras, y una de las que más sufrió el efecto de los maquillajes, vestidos y peinados fue la actriz Natalie Portman.
Senator Amidala, your tragedy on the landing platform, terrible. Seeing you alive brings warm feelings to my heart.
Do you have any idea who is behind this attack?
Our intelligence points to disgruntled spice miners on the moons of Naboo.
I think that Count Dooku is behind it.
He is a political idealist, not a murderer.
You know, m'lady, Count Dooku was once a Jedi. He couldn't assassinate anyone. It's not in his character.
But for certain, Senator, in grave danger, you are.
You had so many hairdos. I mean, how much work was that?
Well, it wasn't work for me, no. But the hairdressers did. You know, it ranged from probably about an hour to 2 hours to do the hair.
Every day?
Yeah. It was more like an hour. They were wonderful. They would figure out ways to do it as quickly as possible.
There was a change of clothes also. The first time you had like those big things. And
well, someone's got to change clothes because the Jedi are in like the same stinky outfits all the time.
You get to keep any of the dresses or?
No. There's a very serious archiving system here, so we don't exactly.
La película costó más de 120 millones de dólares, pero lleva juntados más de 400 y seguirá juntando más millones en todo el mundo. estamos viendo las escenas de peleas en el detrás de cámara. Cada una de estas luchas estaba totalmente ensayada y
there's a lot of shots, like a lot of digital effects, also not the backgrounds and everything. How many people work in this?
Well, at Industrial Light and Magic, where they do the special effects part of it, there's about 250 people working there that have been working on the film. And then there's another 250 people that, you know, worked on the set.
Tendrá sentido.
And this role was kind of tough because there's a lot of fighting there. It's
yes,
very physical role.
Yes, yeah, it's a very physically demanding role. I had to be in decent shape for it. I went to Australia about a month beforehand to learn how to wield the lightsaber and learn the choreography to the fights, which was just, you know, so much fun. It's every kid's dream to learn how to play with a lightsaber.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah.
I am concerned for my Padawan. He is not ready to be given this assignment on his own yet.
The Council is confident in its decision, Obi-Wan.
The boy has exceptional skills.
But he still has much to learn, Master. His abilities have made him, well, arrogant.
Yes, yes. A flaw more and more common among Jedi. Too sure of themselves they are. Even the older, more experienced ones.
Remember, Obi-Wan, if the prophecy is true, your apprentice is the only one who can bring the Force back into balance.
Any bruises or...?
Oh, plenty of bruises. You know, every day I didn't really feel like I did my job unless I came home with a scratch or a bruise or something. I did all my own stunts as well, so...
Oh, yeah?
I was throwing myself around the set constantly.
Nobody wants to fight, you know. After seeing the movie, it's like, okay?
Hopefully, yeah.
Well, this time you had a lot of fighting scenes. Must be... Pretty, I mean, you have to prepare for it, or was it?
There's some preparation. We did some training and, you know, practicing every day to make sure you don't hurt anybody. So, you know, we choreographed some of the fights, some of the stuff. It's kind of free form. So I was able to incorporate things that I always wanted to do into my fighting style. It's kind of nice.
So it was a lot of fun, more than the first one, no?
Oh, yeah. Totally. Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Muchas de las escenas fueron filmadas en pleno desierto a unas temperaturas de 50 grados, por lo que para grabar con mayor comodidad se empezaba a filmar desde las 5 de la mañana para aprovechar las horas de menor calor.
How is it? I mean, you just do a shot and immediately start working on it, or it's...
No, we usually do a shot and then I take that shot and I have a group that works with me in the editing rooms. And I design what's going to go in the background and how everything's going to move, and they do those on little tiny computers and very rough versions, and then we take that and we turn that over to ILM. But I sort of have everything cut together and sort of figure out exactly what I want before I turn it over to ILM for them to work on it.
I have successfully made contact with the Prime Minister of Kamino. They are using a bounty hunter named Jango Fett to create a clone army. I have a strong feeling that this bounty hunter is the assassin we are looking for.
Do you think these cloners are involved in the plot to assassinate Senator Amidala?
No, Master, there appears to be no motive.
Do not assume anything, Obi-Wan. Clear your mind must be if you are to discover the real villains behind this plot.
Yes, Master. They say Master Cyberdeus placed an order for a clone army at the request of the Senate almost 10 years ago. I was under the impression he was killed before that. Did the Council ever authorize the creation of a clone army?
No. Whoever placed that order did not have the authorization of the Jedi Council.
Bring him here. Question him. We will.
Yes, Master. I will report back when I have him.
Blind we are. If creation of this clone army, we could not see.
I think it is time we inform the Senate that our ability to use the Force is diminished.
Only the Dark Lord of the Sith knows of our weakness. If informed the Senate is, multiply our adversaries will.
There were a lot of changes also, not during the shooting. I mean, you add a few scenes afterwards, or...?
Well, yeah, I design a film to where I shoot, and then I go and cut and work on the film a little bit, then I come back and shoot some more. Then I go back and cut some more, and then I go back and shoot some more. So most people shoot it all, and it's done, and then cut it. It's like an assembly line. Mm-hmm. I don't do it in the assembly line way. I do it sort of gather material and sort of, it's more like doing a painting where you paint and then you step back and look at it and then go back and paint some more.
Yeah, but isn't it more expensive that way? Like,
no, not if you organize it properly. It's actually much less expensive.
Oh, yeah?
And ultimately you get, I think, a better work out of the project.
El director de animación también le dio vida a algunos personajes generados por computadora que son familiares para todos los aficionados de las Guerras de las Galaxias, incluyendo un Yoda generado totalmente por computadora. Estos efectos le dan a Yoda mucho más movimiento, que le permiten al personaje desempeñar un papel más importante en la acción y el drama, a diferencia de sus previas apariciones en la saga. La mayoría de los personajes que aparecen en Star Wars son creados digitalmente, por lo que en muchos casos...
You have to, I mean, when you have someone like that, where you have a scene with them, it's like, you have the answers, or you have, they should test you and...
Well, somebody's doing the voiceover for you while you're doing it. George kind of tells you where he is, so you know what to look.
El rodaje de esta película dura varios meses, pero se filma de un modo muy particular, en partes. Muchos actores, como la actriz Natalie Portman, que estudia en una facultad de Estados Unidos, no podía estar presente en cada locación y en cada fecha de filmación. El productor de la película nos contó cómo hicieron.
What about the actors? You have to bring the actors like many times to...
We bring them probably 3 or 4 times during the post-production process, but we build that into their overall deal, and we shoot wherever they are or whatever the easiest place for them to get to. So often we may have 2 actors that aren't available at the same time. We'll shoot one at one time and we'll shoot the other at another time. We go to them. It's mail order filmmaking.
Haciendo todos los secretos de cómo se hizo Star Wars, pero tienen ganas de conocer un poco la propiedad, lo que es Skywalker Ranch. Estamos aquí con la casa, miren lo que es esto, es una cosa impresionante. No puedo creer, yo me quedo a vivir acá. Es un lugar muy, pero muy lindo, es gigante aparte, pero bueno, todo esto será tras la pausa. Vamos a conocer todos los secretos entonces de Skywalker Ranch aquí en este especial de Star Wars.
Great pleasure to see you again, lady.
It has been far too long, Master Kenobi. Annie? My goodness, you've grown.
So have you. You've grown more beautiful, I mean. Just being around her again is intoxicating.
Be mindful of your thoughts, Anakin. They betray you. You have made a commitment to the Jedi Order, a commitment not easily broken.
Please don't look at me like that.
Why not?
It makes me feel uncomfortable.
Sorry, m'lady.
It must be difficult having sworn your love to the Jedi, not being able to do the things you like.
I'll be with the people that I love.
Are you allowed to love? I thought that was forbidden for a Jedi. You're making fun of me.
No, I'd be much too frightened to tease a senator. We could keep it a secret.
I'd be living a lie. I couldn't do that. Could you, Anakin?
She's a politician and they are not to be trusted.
I've heard this lesson before.
You haven't learned anything, Anakin.
It's all Obi-Wan's fault. He's holding me back!
You're not all-powerful, Anakin.
Well, I should be. Someday I will be the most powerful Jedi ever.
Thank you.
Segundo bloque de este especial de Star Wars, episodio 2, y yo estoy como un niño aquí, pero no lo puedo creer, estar en el Skywalker Ranch es un lugar increíble. Estamos viendo de lo que es no solamente la casa de George Lucas, y acá tiene un lago, tiene animales, tiene de todo, sino que también tiene el lugar donde trabaja. ¿Qué mejor que traer el trabajo a casa, en especial cuando tenés un lugar de casa como este, ¿no? Que está en las afueras de San Francisco, en Marin County, queda muy cerquita, ¿no? Son unos 50 minutos más o menos en auto desde el centro de la ciudad. Y aquí es donde se hace también toda la parte de edición y un montón de los procesos de las películas que él va produciendo. Hay muchísima tecnología en este lugar y por supuesto que valen millones y millones que tienen ganas de meterse en la intimidad de este lugar. Vamos a ver aquí en este especial.
Esta es la casa de George Lucas, ubicada en Marin County, en las afueras de San Francisco, en Estados Unidos. Es un gigantesco rancho de cientos de hectáreas, con seguridad propia, y no solo eso, tiene una central de policía, que viven y tienen su comisaría dentro del rancho, y se cuida todos los alrededores del lugar con cámaras. Además de policía, Lucas tiene su propio equipo de bomberos, con dos camiones, y 12 hombres que viven allí y cuidan que no se inicie ningún incendio en los cientos de hectáreas que este millonario posee. No solo deben proteger la casa principal, que tiene un look muy tradicional, al mejor estilo de la serie Dallas, sino también todos los edificios en los que se trabaja para hacer sus películas. Se editan los efectos especiales y donde están muchas de las oficinas de producción de la compañía de Lucas. También posee hectáreas de viñedos y junto con Francis Ford Coppola se ocupan de producir parte del mejor vino del norte de California. Además de animales, que él también cría en su rancho, muchos de los animales que se acercan a uno son salvajes y son parte de esas montañas adueñadas por el famoso director. También tiene varias casas donde sus amigos se pueden quedar a dormir y donde realizamos las entrevistas con cada uno de los actores. Cada una de esas piezas lleva el nombre de algún famoso director o estrella de cine que él admira, como la casa Betty Davis.
Beautiful ranch here.
Yeah, it is. Gorgeous, yeah. Isn't it? Man, I wish I could say it was mine, but it's not.
But you can stay here, I guess, whenever you want.
La filmación se realizó en varios países. Filmaron en Australia, en Inglaterra, en Italia, en Túnez, en España y en Estados Unidos. Los actores pasaban mucho tiempo alejados de sus seres queridos. Hayden Christensen, el nuevo galán de moda en Hollywood, decidió hacer algo al respecto.
And how was it with your family and with your friends? I mean, everybody wanted to go to the set and see things, or
I eventually brought my entire family out, and they came and stayed with me for about a week, and really enjoyed themselves. We were filming out in Australia, and so they came and saw the sets, and then traveled around Australia a little bit.
It must be quite thrilling seeing the set and everything. And
yeah, well, when there is a set, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, most of the time it's blue screens, no?
A lot of the time it's blue screen, yeah.
Your family must be also like, take me to the set, please, or your friends.
Actually, nobody's ever asked that.
No?
To be taken to the set. friends of mine.
No? No? Well, I ask you for the next one.
Okay, fine.
Take me.
I'll check it.
También se necesitan de muchos artistas talentosos para ilustrar la visión de George Lucas y con ello darle una nueva apariencia a la saga de la Guerra de las Galaxias. Al trabajar sin el beneficio de un guión, porque en esta etapa de la historia todavía estaba en desarrollo el guión, el diseñador de producción y el supervisor de diseño se pusieron a trabajar durante varios meses en la preproducción para con ello establecer a grandes rasgos el estilo y la apariencia del ataque de los clones. Los nuevos mundos del film eran una de las prioridades principales. El diseño de vehículos, de droides y de espadas láser son parte muy importante de la realización y se construyeron desde los primeros meses de concepción de este proyecto. Se invirtieron más de 15 millones de dólares en construcción de vehículos y escenografías.
I mean, you get to keep any of the props or anything? Or?
Not yet, I plan on being in the next movie.
Yeah, to put it in the contract.
Exactly. Keep, no. Keep things. Yeah. You know, you don't steal things, so they let you come back.
Yeah, but the third one is okay.
Exactly. After that, I can keep everything.
En episodio 2 se inicia la historia de amor entre Anakin Skywalker y quien fuera la reina Amidala, y ahora una senadora, cuya vida corre peligro. Como podemos ver, en el detrás de escena había una muy buena onda entre los actores, tanto que se rumoreó que se había transformado en pareja real, pero que el amor solo duró mientras estaban filmando. Hayden, el galán de la película, vive en Toronto, Canadá, con su familia, y ella se encuentra en Boston estudiando en la facultad.
This time it was different with you. You had to fight and you also had a love story this
right.
time. So there's a big change in this story. And do you know anything about the third episode, or does George Lucas tell you anything, or is...
I basically know what everyone knows about the third episode. You know, it's sort of the major story point, so I don't feel like I have any, you know, secrets to reveal, unfortunately. Because I would. I've got a big mouth.
Please don't look at me like that. It makes me feel uncomfortable.
Must be difficult having sworn your love to the Jedi, not being able to do the things you like.
I'm in charge of security here, m'lady.
We could keep it a secret.
I'd be living a lie. I couldn't do this.
Miles de fans estaban esperando en Estados Unidos semanas antes del estreno, y los fans en todo el mundo son muy intensos, y los actores de esta saga sienten la presión de esos fans.
And is it a pressure for you being in such a huge movie and or?
Well, I don't want to make it out to be like this big burden, because obviously it's a very lucky position I'm in, and I'm extremely grateful for it, and I enjoy the majority of it. But obviously it changes your lifestyle when, you know, people recognize you and people feel like they own you a little bit, you know, they want to touch you and talk to you and take your time, and it's fine. I like, you know, connecting to fans, and I like seeing, you know, I enjoy meeting people who are truly nice and don't want to hurt you and don't want to do anything bad, you know, but it's still, you know, it's different. It's a different kind of way of being.
And with girls, how is it? Girls go crazy for you? Or?
No, right now I don't really have the time. I'm kind of traveling all over the place, and my focus right now is on my work, and so I don't know, that's where my head's at right now.
You don't get fans just going after you? Or?
No, not yet. No.
But you know that in 2 weeks when the movie is opening, it's going to be a big change, because it's going to be hard to walk on the streets, and I mean, it's like millions and millions of people all over the world expecting this movie, so
yeah,
it's going to be like a huge exposure. And
it's a little daunting, but you know, I was somewhat aware of that when I took the part, and it's something that, you know, you just have to accept.
Muchos actores querían estar en el lugar que a estos pocos privilegiados les tocó estar, pero el esfuerzo diario es grande.
Immortalized, you might say, in the eyes of millions of people. It's very rewarding, very enthralling, and it's magic.
Which was the hardest scene for you?
Well, the hardest thing for me to do, and it's not, you know, to just bust out laughing all the time because I'm there and I'm so happy to be there and amazed that I'm there, to actually go in and do the stuff seriously without having this big smile on my face.
La historia, personajes, ambientes, vehículos y elementos del ataque de los clones enriquecen la saga. Para darle vida a todo eso, Lucas nuevamente regresó a la silla de director y recurrió a la ayuda del guionista Jonathan Hales para depurar el guión. Hales y Lucas tenían una asociación en la serie de televisión El Joven Indiana Jones. Para darle todavía un enfoque más agudo a todos los elementos, Lucas y Hales continuaron mejorando el guión, incluso mientras el vestuario era diseñado y los sets construidos. Tuvieron que construir los escenarios para un guión que no existía. Gran parte del libro constaba de dibujos. El equipo animático jugó un papel fundamental en el film al haber proporcionado informales dibujos en movimiento, más de 400 tomas, que fueron utilizados más tarde por el director, los actores, los editores y los artistas de efectos para previsualizar cómo se verían las escenas finales.
Is it true that we didn't have a script like 2 weeks before shooting?
3 days.
3 days?
3 days before.
Oh. And I was...
That's what addiction to alcohol and tobacco can do for you. That's why you get there. But no, it was a very interesting process. You know, what we tried to do is change the whole dramatic structure of how you make a movie, so it's not so rigid, so that a writer can continue to write right up to the very last minute.
It was just before dawn. They came out of nowhere.
La tecnología digital siempre ha sido un elemento importante en el proceso creativo de George Lucas. Hace 20 años, revolucionó los primeros sistemas de edición de sonido e imagen computadorizados, no lineales. Cuando las cámaras comenzaron a rodar, en junio del 2000, La Guerra de las Galaxias Episodio 2 se convirtió en la primera película de esa envergadura, filmada con cámara de video digital de alta definición, a 24 cuadros por segundo en vez de celuloide.
And you also have like a lot of new technology, the digital cameras also. You think was it a big change? And
it's not really that big a change. The digital cameras actually made it easier for us to make the film and made us move faster. It's more of a technical thing for the person who's making the film than anything else. I think when you see the film, it looks pretty much just like any other film.
In this film, probably the biggest single challenge was technologically that we decided to shoot it completely digitally, not on film at all. So that took a long time to develop.
lot of great engineers from Sony and Panasonic and people at ILM, but it was well worth it for us.
Yeah, and wasn't it scary because you get the camera like a few days before shooting it?
En este episodio se presenta una gran lucha de Jedis. Para eso su productor visitó 20 escuelas de Kendo y clubes de pelea, donde entrevistó a más de 500 espadachines para ocupar los puestos de los Jedis. Mucho trabajo en esta realización y poco tiempo. La presión en todos los que trabajaron era inmensa.
But it must be exhausting. It's a pleasure doing a movie like this, no?
Yeah, it's great to actually finish it and actually see it, because we only got to see, George and I only got to see the final film about 2.5 weeks ago. I mean, we're obviously involved with it every minute, but to be able to see it with the total mix and all the effect shots done is right up to the very last minute. In fact, we were even making changes to the film last week. We were shooting an additional shot that he wanted. So, you know, it's a relief. It's done. He can't make any more changes right now.
Yeah, that's a good part. No
exactly.
More changes.
Well, he'll make them for the DVD, and then he'll make them for another special edition later. He's never finishes, but right now we're done.
Decided to come and rescue you.
Good job.
The process of doing it, do you listen to any advice from anybody, or you just...
No, this is a project that I wrote 30 years ago, and I'm just trying to get it finished. Obviously, I work with a very talented group of the most creative people in the world, really, and probably about, you know, 50 or 60 of them that I'm working very, very closely with. So I do collaborate and work very closely with them and listen to their ideas, and you know, it's, so it's a group effort.
Do you get to show your children anything, like a new invention you made, a new character or something?
Well, they're on the set, so they see the film made, and but when they see it when it's finished, they're just as surprised as everybody else is.
Yeah, but it must be like for children going to the set like this, it must be a lot of fun.
And you look at each other and go forward. They keep coming in. They get you into a little group here in the middle. And then Count Dooku, you'll look up to the just the left of that camera up there.
Guys, everyone, listen up. Anyone who's ready, just step outside the marquee and we'll walk you over to the set.
Uno de los temas más complicados es el manejo de los cientos de extras que representan a los soldados. Cada uno debe tener su armadura y armas y debe estar en el lugar adecuado y hacer los movimientos adecuados. Luego la producción debe organizar cómo se filmará al día siguiente.
All right, here we go then, please. Turn over, please.
Ready? And action!
Background action! Action!
No me digan que no es impresionante este lugar, yo no lo puedo creer, realmente, es que uno se siente como un niño, aparte cuando uno ha crecido viendo las películas de Star Wars, encontrarse en el lugar donde se han hecho, donde está, donde vive este genio que ha creado estas películas es realmente increíble, un placer. Aparte, bueno, nunca, generalmente no invitan a la gente ni a la prensa a estos lugares y bueno, es realmente impresionante estar aquí. Les cuento que tras la pausa vamos a tener muchísimas más cosas sobre Star Wars 2, todos los secretos de cómo se fue haciendo, toda la magia del cine, está aquí en este especial. No se vayan, ya volvemos.
Ay, los amo y...
Millones y millones de dólares para construir este lugar que es realmente increíble. Tiene muchísimas hectáreas y tiene muchísimas comodidades. Y además de eso también ustedes saben que hay muchos secretos de cómo se hizo esta película. Este es el segundo episodio, son en total 6. El siguiente episodio se va a estrenar recién en el 2005. Y hay millones y millones de personas que están en el mundo enloquecidos con esta fiebre de Star Wars. ¿Quieren conocer más secretos? ¿Quieren conocer más sobre el making de esta película? Aquí está.
All the Star Wars films are action films. Episode 2 is no different. And even though it's primarily a mystery and a love story, it has, you know, sizable action.
People getting jacked in this movie. Well, hey, you know, it's a Star Wars movie.
It is the classic big themes that make you think, but then
it's really fun and action-filled and got the fights that are, you know, these modern sword fights.
It's a magical world. Long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. And it continues.
I look at these as the swashbuckling adventures of, you know, the modern era. So these are the new adventures that expand your imagination.
Do you have any idea who is behind this attack?
We will find out who's trying to kill you, Padme.
They're trying to solve a puzzle. Somebody's trying to kill Padme, and they're trying to figure out who and why.
While she's asleep, a droid's come to the window to kill her. So we both sense that at the same moment and save the day.
Obi-Wan goes after them, and I race downstairs to grab a speeder and go after them.
And they go through everything. They're through buildings. They're upside down. They're shooting. It's going to be a fantastic chase.
It's so dense. Every single image has so many things going on.
Follow that speeder! He went that way.
This is a shortcut, I think.
Anakin! How many times have I told you?
Stay away from the park.
Before we had to do miniatures and stop motion, and now we can do things that were unthinkable before.
I mean, you couldn't even think about having a chase through a city.
In reality, to do it, we were in a speeder that was rocking about, and that actually made you feel rather sick after a while. It's like going on a fairground ride over and over again, where you're not allowed to go and have a hot dog, you know?
That was a tough day. I was just being thrown around all day, trying to hold on and climbing all over the speeder. It's pretty nutty.
You know I don't like it when you do that.
Sorry, Master. I forgot you don't like flying.
Well, you've lost it.
If you'll excuse me.
I hate it when he does that.
They end up in the bowels of Coruscant, which we haven't seen before, where they crash and take off on foot.
We go chasing through the streets. It was lots of fun to shoot, you know, and just knocking extras over and fell down a few times. You know, you get lots of cuts and bruises filming this.
While Anakin is sent to protect Padme, Obi-Wan goes off to see if he can solve the mystery of who's trying to kill her.
Dangerous and disturbing this puzzle is.
I go on a kind of Dick Tracy detective spree. It's good. It's really good. Then the plot deepens, you know.
They are using a bounty hunter named Jango Fett to create a clone army.
Wait.
It starts off at long range because once Obi gets near him with his lightsaber, he's going to be in trouble.
Yeah, I did lose my lightsaber, and that's something a Jedi should never do. But it was raining and it slipped.
Jango Fett is able to escape, and there's this wild chase through an asteroid field that is really spectacular.
Blast, this is why I hate flying.
This time I get to fly a really cool spaceship. A little starfighter of my own. A bit like Luke Skywalker does in his X-Wing when he goes to find Yoda. Which is brilliant. It looks fantastic, this thing.
After a really series of complex events, Obi-Wan gets captured in Geonosis, and Padme is hell-bent on going and saving Obi-Wan.
They land on Geonosis, and then they get trapped into this droid factory.
They made me look so cool. They put me on a conveyor belt with nothing. It was all blue around me. So I basically had to run and dodge things and just completely making stuff up. And then they painted stuff around me that looks like I'm like jumping through things and I look so brave. It was pretty exciting. I felt very action star.
Finally, both of them are caught and they are sentenced to be executed.
First they're about to be killed by the monsters and then shot by some droids, and then the Jedi come to save them. In Phantom Menace there were four or five Jedi. In this one there are 400 or 500 Jedi. We've never seen that before. There's always been a couple of Jedi fighting each other.
Yeah, I think this is the first time that we really get to see all the Jedi in action, which is an amazing sight.
All Jedi don't fight exactly alike, so that each Jedi has his own particular style.
A lot of the aggression that I hold in my character is exemplified in my fighting style. Jedis are always supposed to be very much in control of their emotions, and Anakin maybe loses control a little bit and some of the darkness emerges.
We've not seen Mace fight yet, and we know that he's second only to Yoda.
Now I finally get to do it. I mean, it would be a shame for me to participate in a film like this and never get to use my lightsaber. So I'm amped.
I was thinking about a style for him, but it's Sam Jackson's style, you know, that he has so much style of his own, there's very little you have to do.
Since I'm supposedly the second baddest person in the universe, I dispense people pretty quickly. Use as little energy as possible, but I'm pretty lethal.
I've probably done more sword fights on celluloid than any actor in history. And this fight is greater than anything I've ever been involved in.
It's not very fun not to have a lightsaber when everyone else gets a lightsaber. And I get these guns that look like little hair dryers.
It was interesting to see her in combat mode.
She's a real fighter.
They wipe out a lot of the droids and everything, and they escape in these gunships. And then you come out of the arena and you realize that there's a bigger war going on, that all the Jedi have arrived with clones, and the clone army starts attacking the droid army.
Hasn't been a full-scale war since the formation of the Republic.
Begun this clone war has.
And this takes the idea of a battle scene and takes it to the level that we'd always sort of been aspiring to but never quite got there. We have clones and droids and flying termites and rockets taking off, flying gunships, ground troops, 200 Jedi. It's much, much more complex than anything we've ever attempted before.
There's some really good action in this movie. People getting wiped out, man. There's some wipeouts in this movie.
A lot of people think episode 2 is just a sweet, intimate love story. But actually, I think it's truly the most action-packed of all the films that we've done so far.
Ahora solo resta esperar la última parte, el episodio 3, que completa toda la serie de Star Wars, y los fans en todo el mundo ya desesperan por conocer detalles.
You know anything about it, or?
I mean, just sort of the obvious, what everyone can, you know, speculate from the last film, that, you know, maybe I have to murder all of the Jedi, and there has to be some sort of falling apart between myself and Obi-Wan. But other than that, I don't know.
You're going to be back.
And I will turn into Darth Vader. Yes, you will.
And you're already working on the third episode, or?
I've already started to write the third one.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm not going to take a vacation this time.
Yeah, yeah, you should.
Everybody said, don't do that to us.
And the next one is when in 2 years? Like, it's
3 years.
3 years.
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll be 3 years from today, or next week.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Congratulations for this one. It's
okay.
Really good.
Thank you.
Y este modo estamos llegando entonces al final de este especial de Star Wars Episodio 2. Estamos aquí de Skywalker Ranch, que queda hacia el norte de California, un poquito a las afueras, San Francisco, como una hora de auto cruzando el Golden Gate. Es un lugar pero muy lindo. Estamos muy agradecidos, obviamente, que nos hayas invitado a este lugar y acá hayamos conocido todos los secretos de cómo se hace la película y de cómo es este lugar, que es tan, pero tan impresionante. Muchas gracias también a todos ustedes por habernos acompañado. Nos reencontraremos en otro momento. Hasta luego.